We are on the south end of Palmdale now. That's the State Highway 14 running north and south. The San Andreas Fault pretty much cuts across perpendicularly to it. Just to the north of this tectonic boundary, we have a hill with the highway cutting through it, and it's very revealing of the tectonic pressures in this area. We are in the heart of the Big Bend here, where the San Andreas runs in a more easterly direction, but also we're in the thick of the zone of compression, where there's a lot more convergent pressure on the two plate boundaries. Here we can see what were once horizontal strata, tilted upright, vertically almost, some of it completely folded over. This is an old aerial photo from 1952, before the Highway 14 was built. It's a study by the UC Santa Barbara of the faulting in the area. And as you can see, there's quite a bit of secondary faulting. After a lot of the folding occurred, eventually all that pressure and folding gave way to some shearing and secondary faulting, including the Little Rock Fault, which is right along the north edge of the hill. And it's basically a parallel right lateral slipping fault to the San Andreas. There's also a curious kind of an angled south-oriented thrust fault, in addition to numerous other little faults here. This is called a Rydell shear that runs kind of diagonally to its parent fault. That would be the San Andreas. So when we have a situation where two right lateral faults are parallel to one another, you get the inner plane of, say, this one to the north, the Little Rock Fault, going to the left, the inner plane of the south one, the San Andreas, going to the right, which gives a certain twisting action. Next, we're heading down the Pear Blossom Highway to another tortured landscape, the Punchbowl Formation. We are looking toward the northern edge of the San Gabriel Mountain Range. It's a transverse range. It runs more east to west. It's also considered to be a geologically young and growing mountain range. The San Gabriels are made up largely of granitic material, which came up back when this was a subduction zone back about 30 million years ago. There was another plate called the Farallon Plate subducting underneath the North American plate. When that material was finally exhausted, due to something to do with the densities of the crustal material, the adjacent Pacific plate kind of slammed up against the North American plate, did not subduct, started to become a transform fault. But this tremendous amount of convergent pressure occurred, which caused these fairly young mountains to be pushed up more and more. Hence, they are still growing. A lot of these sandstones we see before the mountains were alluvial deposits laid down much further down from the mountains. All those pressures sheared them and squeezed them up toward the more granitic mountains and kind of put them a little bit more out of place than where they should be. This may be where the Devil's Punch Bowl gets its namesake. We can see a curving of the sandstone here into a bowl-like formation. These sandstones were laid down about 12 million years ago, then uplifted into these syncline formations, meaning they were sheared and uplifted from the outside, and they dipped down toward the center. The formation is bordered on the north by the San Andreas Fault and another fault called the Pinion Fault, and on the south by the Punchbowl Fault, which is a right lateral fault considered to be extinct now. I couldn't find a clear mapping of it, but we can see a scarring here somewhat on the satellite view, which may indicate roughly where it is. The Punchbowl Fault goes about 44 kilometers up higher into the mountains, where it passes Wrightwood and joins up with the San Andreas. There is a huge twist in this whole formation in this one area. it's very complex what happened here. I really can't get my brain around it, but it may have to do with a similar situation as with the road cutting in Palmdale and the Little Rock Fault, where we had two parallel right lateral slipping faults, and the internal planes are twisting, going in opposing directions. But it's very complex, like I said. It's an awesome place to visit. It's totally spectacular. There are great hikes in the area. It's highly recommended. And I want to thank you all for watching.